Sunrise Radio.
Good morning, it's 10:19.
You're on Sunrise Radio with me, Shabnam Sahi. It gives me great pleasure to say a big warm welcome to Dr. Steve Cox, the Chief Executive at CRY, Cardiac Risk in the Young. Dr. Steve, this is National Heart Month. You are the Chief Executive of this very important charity. Welcome to Sunrise.
Thank you very much for inviting me on. Really appreciate it.
As the Chief, can you tell us how long you've been working with the charity and what your role involves?
Well, I think my journey with CRY began actually a few years before CRY was even founded. I was a young aspiring tennis player out in the States, and I was identified with a very dangerous condition. Hmm. And that identification of that heart condition resulted in the end of my tennis career, really, and I had to return to the UK. And it was basically, at that time, very little was known about these conditions. And I was only 18 at the time. It was 1992. And my mother and myself, we learned a lot about this condition over the next year or so. And at the same time, another young athlete, a footballer, John Marshall, died of the same condition that I'd been identified on through screening. And those two stories together led to a lot of media attention, and people started writing to my mother, whose children had died from these conditions, and she started supporting them. She was a counsellor at the time, and she was helping them to understand what had happened to their child. And then a few years later, in 1995, Alison, my mother, then founded the charity Cardiac Risk in the Young. So I really came to this a few years before CRY even started. And then I went to university, and then I became much more involved in the charity from 2000 onward.
Wow. So your association with this formidable charity, clearly born from personal experience. Now, talk us through the key services that CRY funds to help prevent sudden cardiac death in young people.
There are four key areas to our work, and these are awareness, support, screening and research. Through awareness, we want young people to know that they can have a heart condition, that it can affect them. We want them to know that at least 12 fit and healthy young people die every week in the UK. This is one of the most common causes of death in young people and the most common cause of death in young athletes. But we also want them to know about how they can prevent these tragedies. From a support perspective, we want families to contact us, to engage in our peer-to-peer support program, to learn about what caused the death, but also through the My Heart Network, if they've been identified. The screening program is really incredible. We enable any young person, whether they have symptoms or not, to have the opportunity to be screened. But then through research, we're helping to prevent young sudden deaths into the future, to understand more about these conditions.
Dr. Steve, why do you think it is so important for young people, even if they don't have any symptoms, to have their heart screened? Is it because when we're young, we're brash, we're confident, we think these are things that happen to other people, not to us?
That's so true. We very often we switch off with these conditions because we think that fit and healthy young people can't possibly have heart conditions. But of course they can. As I said, this is one of the most common causes of death in young people. One in 300 people we screen will have a potentially life-threatening cardiac condition. One in 100 people we screen will have a condition which may not be life-threatening now, but could cause major problems in their fourth or fifth decade of life if they don't know about it now, have it monitored and treated when necessary. And of course, 80% of young sudden deaths occur with no prior symptoms whatsoever. The first sign that there's a problem is when there's a collapse, a cardiac arrest. And then really, you know, our aim as a charity is to prevent that tragedy, to prevent that cardiac arrest from occurring through cardiac screening. We've also, one final point is, we've seen through the research which has come out in Italy over the last 20, 30 years, that when they've introduced screening into support, 89% of young sudden deaths are prevented. So when we consider there are more than 600 deaths every year, 89% of those can be prevented through proactive cardiac screening.
Now, we are an Asian station. We've been the heartbeat of the Asian community, British Asian community, for over 30 years, pun intended. So, Dr. Steve, are young people from a BAME background more at risk of heart conditions?
These are really important questions, and we need to do more research in this area to understand these cardiac conditions, how they affect the BAME community. Sometimes we hear of stories of, you know, the young people who are taken from families in the Asian community, and they almost have a way of describing this as something which is known within their community, but they don't realize these are underlying cardiac conditions which are causing those deaths. So we need to do more research in this area. That's one of the areas which CRI is really keen to progress, and we have teams working on that right now to understand if the incidence of young sudden death is the same, but also the number of cardiac conditions which are identified in this community. So we're really keen for all young people to be screened, but particularly for people from the BAME community to come forward and do the screening and help with research, but also to help identify problems if they have those conditions.
Let's talk about the ongoing pandemic, COVID-19. This has been very challenging for everyone, but how much has the pandemic impacted on CRI as a charity?
On March the 16th, that's when we held our last cardiac screening. All events after that date were either postponed or cancelled. That's resulted in 28,000 appointments since then, which have been cancelled. So it's had a massive impact on our screening program. Also, fundraising it's a third of what it was before pre-COVID times. Mm. So once again, it's had a massive impact on us as a charity, like many other charities and organizations. But our support program has continued. There is a huge demand for support for young people who have been either identified with conditions or families who have so sadly suffered a tragedy, and they're looking for how to talk to other families and help through this horrendous time for them. So that has continued, and we were very quick to adapt to a new normal as all our staff started to work remotely. So much of what we do continues as normal, but also sadly so much has had to be put on hold until we start to find a way through this.
Dr. Steve, I know we're not out of the woods yet, and I still got to ask you this. When do you hope that young people, including our listeners here at Sunrise, might be able to start booking in for heart screenings again?
Well, I mean, the optimism in me would like this to happen as soon as possible. But realistically, I think it will be very challenging to get this going before probably autumn time. Hopefully we will do. There are many factors which we have to consider. Our doctors, our research fellows and our screening team all work within the NHS. So many of these are now frontline staff helping at this time. So we have to wait for them to be released from their services to the NHS to get the screening program back up and running. But let's fingers crossed it will be as soon as possible. But, I think probably autumn is a realistic time.
And finally, CRI is marking its 25th anniversary this year. Are there any milestones or achievements you can single out over the amazing journey you've had in these last 25 years?
That's a tough question. I think from a support program perspective, what we've done since the start of CRI and providing peer-to-peer support, but also funding, it's a really difficult area, it's pathology, but helping families understand what caused the tragedy. Mm. This is so important when a young person dies, to understand what has caused that tragedy. But from the positive side, the screening program is unbelievable. It's we've screened more than 220,000 people. That's more than 700 young people who have had their lives transformed and potentially their lives saved through cardiac screening over that period of time. And we're now screening in pre-COVID times, more than 30,000 young people every year. And that's an incredible service. It's a free service. Young people just go to testmyheart.org.uk to book on whether they've got symptoms or not. It's a free service at the point of access because of the incredible support we receive from communities throughout the UK raising funds to offer that service to young people if they're between the age of 14 and 35. So I think the scale of the screening program now has to be our greatest achievement now.
For more information on that, listeners, please head over to c-r-y.org.uk/sunriseradio. Dr. Steve Cox, Chief Executive of CRI Cardiac Risk in the Young, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
This is Sunrise, the best mix of music.